Yeah, could you play the Led Zeppelin?
Play the what?
The Led Zeppelin Jewish thing.
The Led Zeppelin Jewish thing?
Yeah.
Led Zeppelin Jewish thing?
Yeah, the thing was...
Zimfar da Zeppelin?
Yeah.
What's Jewish about that?
Well,
is Zimfar Jewish? Oh, God, what a yahoo.
WIOD.
Well, I've heard better, but not bad.
Well,
not bad.
That's a little experimental for the first time. It was okay. We're kind of breaking new ground there. 128 at WIOD. That lightning round coming up in about 20 minutes. That's the kind of thing that we strive for in this business, man, is working for mung brains, okay? In fact, don't we have a little special dedication? Yeah, I think we got something special here for Mike Disney.
Oh.
Okay, now the rumor is that...
Hold on, Neil. Hold on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Neil. Hold on.
I thought it was going to get better after you got to the phone. It's getting worse.
Okay. I got to tell you something.
Yeah.
I'm dying over here.
Weak. That doesn't start for 15 or 20 minutes. Oh, look at that. He's caught on glue. Boca, hello. Nobody there. Palm Beach.
Yes, Neil, this is Z-Donna. I wish you'd please...
Dade County, hello.
Hello?
She will never be on this show again, okay? And if I go on vacation and you put her on, you're going to be selling hot dogs and some bread. Hello.
Hello?
Yes.
I love you, Glenn.
You know who this is?
No.
Long distance.
Where are you calling from?
I think, Glenn, you're great.
Where are you?
California.
Michigan.
Michigan? Mm.
This is Madam X.
It is?
Yep.
Are you a Michigander?
No, I'm Michigan.
That's the truest thing she ever said. Boy, what a quinella that was, man.
Oh,
the two of them back to back. And isn't it amazing how that card, that hostile card we got from you-know-who that called a couple of calls back, was something to do about Madam X calling, and I thought it was her. And here they are on back to back. Now, didn't somebody once say, some very famous philosopher, that there are no coincidences?
This is getting good.
Wow.
This is getting lively.
Shocking.
Isn't this interesting?
Yeah. What a pair those two are. Broward, hello.
Will I marry McLaren? Oh, love, what can I do? We're worried now, but we won't be worried long.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. You see, you people out there in the audience, you think you can really dazzle us and outdo us? Well, I got a real stinking surprise for that caller. Oh, that's the wrong cut. I got a real surprise for that caller. Yeah. Well, listen, nobody's perfect, okay? Except the boss. He's a perfect idiot. Boy, is that quick or what, huh?
Guess who's in the building? Guess who's about to walk into the studio? Right on cue.
Now, you were distracted, but did you hear that?
Yes.
That was tight.
Perfect. It was perfect. And he brought his Wendy's in, so we feel sorry for him.
Wendy's? You mean this man didn't go to Char Hut?
Amazing.
Boy.
Yeah. No.
Is there
Char Hut around here?
Around here, no.
No.
Oh, that's the excuse, huh? You know, some excuse.
I would have to go up university, and I stay off university. You know that. I never touch university.
I think that was perfect to play that song with Stan in here.
Mm-hmm.
But I won't be worried.
Okay.
So how is...
Isn't that astonishing?
It is astonishing.
An obscure... Well, not obscure, but an old ancient Kingston Trio record, and we just pull it right out. And the CD, too.
So how was the garage sale Saturday? The
Miami Vice garage sale?
I didn't find out about it till it was all over.
Oh, jeez. Can't we hold this for after 2 o'clock? Because I'm not in the mood for this crap today, I'll tell you that
right
now.
What is your problem today, Uncle Neil?
You don't want to know, man.
Jeez,
this
you couldn't find out about Knott's Landing?
This place is so... That should be our worst problem, should be Knott's Landing.
I watch L.A. Law, by the way. Laurie watches Knott's Landing. I watch L.A. Law.
Well,
can you believe they lost the baby?
No, I can believe that,
yeah.
Because that's logical for that show, that's, right?
Yeah.
Can you believe that Susan Day is going dark again? That's what I really like. I couldn't stand her.
Going dark?
Yeah, she is.
What's all this feedback in here? Man, it's just enough to make you want to puke.
Oh, God. And how about that Benny, huh?
I thought I heard that earlier on your show.
No, you didn't hear any feedback, okay?
No, the puking.
Isn't that great that he's going to have a girlfriend now? Isn't that exciting, Benny?
What happened to the rest of my cards?
Who? Benny.
Oh, Benny, yeah, Benny driving
have
the
a girlfriend.
Rolls Royce.
Yeah,
that's great.
Incredible. With the man
I was
going
to call you after that show because I hadn't talked to you for a long time, and I figured you would be home about 11 o'clock.
I tape it, watch it.
Oh.
I watch it on Sunday morning. It's a wonderful Sunday morning show, you know? And,
Rich doesn't look like he's losing any weight at all. But Neil doesn't either, so.
Yes, he does.
So welcome to Horse Talk with history, Neil Rogers.
I need help.
Broward, hello.
No changes.
Barbara. Yeah, this is going to be a stampede lightning round today, so
no
stay
question.
Tuned.
No question.
Broward, hello.
I'm holding for the lightning round.
Hold on. Palm Beach, hello.
Way to pick the race.
What?
Neil.
Yeah.
Hey, way to pick the race, man.
So how much did you bet on it?
That's I didn't take your advice. I went with that stinking Playboy horse.
Western Playboy, he's still running. Dead last. 15.
Speaking of the Playboys, I was going around the horn on the TV dial Friday night.
You're going around the horn, huh?
So to speak.
Yeah.
But Gary Lewis and the Playboys were on.
No.
She's just my style.
You're kidding. Gary Lewis and the Playboys were on TV?
Friday night.
And they did. And they did what?
In fact, it was on. So they did Just My Style. Count Me In. There it is.
I'm going to tell you something. We are so on top of the music world on this show that Bill Wise is having an emergency meeting, seriously, with the jocks from GTR out in the hallway.
Good talk up. Good.
Ryan Hyland is not dead.
He's not.
He's not dead.
Who am I thinking of? You know who I'm thinking of? Who looked like Brian Hyland? Was that young actor who was just an incredible-looking guy. He was in that movie with Carl Malden and...
Oh, Ricky Nelson.
Get out of here. Boy, you are tacky. With Warren Beatty and Carl Malden.
I don't know who it is.
Oh, now I'm going to go nuts. Brandon DeWilde.
Mm-hmm.
Never heard of him. That's
well, he's dead. He got killed in a car crash.
Hey, Brian Hyland was down here last year and did a concert. He was in good form.
Was he?
And for the bird. Private school's on tomorrow night.
Yeah, how about that? What a week, huh?
How about it, huh?
Yeah.
You know? Oh, you mean with Phoebe Cates?
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Woo! Oh, and I got my rooftop tape here now, and with no Cubs game on tonight, it'll keep me busy, I guess.
And one suggestion, if I may.
Yes.
That noise, followed by the sigh. Remember that woman's sigh that you used to have on every now and then?
All right, wait a minute. Let's see if we can try it here. Now, this is a little experiment.
Nice.
Now, what noise are you talking about?
The
multiple one?
That one.
Or the buzzer?
Yeah. No, not with the buzzer.
What?
That pipic type noise.
Okay.
And then with...
All right, hold on.
Oh, yeah. That did it for me.
Okay.
Thanks.
Have a good life, pal. You'll need it. 137 at WIOD. Stan Major's in the building, eating that halusious-looking stuff right now, and he'll be filling in for Steve, who's hungover from his birthday party, and we'll be right back.
It's 7:45 in the morning.
On News Talk Radio 610, WIOD.
139 at WIOD. I think it's about time we got things straightened out here because all these horrendous comments about Rick Nelson and Brandon DeWilde and all these dead artists.
Dead.
Yeah, dead.
Uh-huh. Bobby Darin.
Next you'll be talking about Lucille Ball.
Yeah.
Tasteless, disgusting. Mm-hmm. And Gary Lewis and the Playboys who went through that trauma in Vietnam and came back, couldn't speak for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Alleged,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
I think it's sickening. And I think people ought to stop playing the music and doing all this crap. Have a little respect, right?
How'd I know he was going to do something?
Gee, I don't know.
140 WIOD.
That's a pretty good talk up there, Glenn.
Yeah,
thanks. You did a great talk up. Have you got Dion the Wanderer?
Yeah.
I love that.
Everybody loves a clown.
Okay. Well, we just had to see where it was, okay? Now, he's okay now. He was on TV over the weekend, right? If you're on TV, you must be okay. I mean, Bundy was on TV. Okay, let's go to Broward. Hello.
Hi, can I talk to Neil?
Speaking.
Really?
Well, I guess if you want me to say no.
No, I can't believe I got through.
Why not? Easy to get through on this show.
Happy Monday.
Yeah, happy birthday. Happy Monday. Happy Shavuos. Is that it?
I can't handle it.
What's happening over there now? Are you crumbling? Are you falling apart on me?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
Okay, well, listen, have a great life.
Disaster, that guy. Just a mess.
What did you want to hear, The Wanderer?
Yeah. I love the intro.
Well, I figure
it's a great
Stan
talk up
can
right
certainly there relate to that particular song, yeah?
Yeah.
You know who wrote this?
No.
Ernie Maresca, who had one hit. That was a little dangerous, wasn't it? Ernie Maresca, Shout, Shout, Knock Yourself Out. Do you remember
now,
that?
Now, didn't you play a bit of that last week? Just,
what?
Just about that much of that record.
I might have.
Because I've sang it all weekend.
Really?
Yeah. So you had to do that because I didn't. I don't listen to music stations. They all suck. Now, he lives down here, right?
Dion?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Absolutely.
Well, Dion lives here, and we got Rick A., who's the best friend of Rick Rob Lowe. Oh, this is the one that's got the Zamfir and the Pan Flute. Have you heard that? All right, just a minute now. Listen to the instrumental background. Shocking. And it comes up pretty soon, like...
Oh, you mean today?
Wow. Now, wait a minute. Come on, Zamfir, get into this, will you? That I was born to cry, yeah, cry. This isn't the one, is it?
Wrong cut.
Is this the wrong cut?
But other than that, it was great. You know, that was the...
Wait a minute. It's not in there. It's no pan flute.
Other than that, though, it was great.
Is it Little Diane? Is that the one with the pan flute and Zamfir?
I don't think
well,
so.
Thanks for the tease.
Yeah, it's Little Diane. Right? What do you got, Sharon? Wants to know if you want to come, Oh, no. No. Dion lives in North Bay Village. Okay, here we go now. Wait a minute. You hear that? There's Zamfir and the pan flute in the background. Actually, it's a guy with three combs. So Dion lives in North Bay Village, which means he may listen to this show. Of course, if Stan was on, he'd be saying, okay, Dion, if you know the sound of my voice, Mr.
Come
President,
on, Dion,
if you're over there with your buddy B.B. Rebozo. See, Stan thinks that everybody's listening to him, no matter, you know, even if they live in Seattle.
Well, the most amazing thing is that they still think that I'm on the air. There's a wonderful guy. There's a wonderful security guy for one of the judges over at the Broward County Courthouse, but he thinks I'm still on WSNews.
Really? Wow.
Now, that's going back, huh?
Yeah, that sounds like the Broward County Courthouse. They're really in touch with the times over
there.
There's
a wonderful guy named Bill. I saw him out in the hallway the other day.
Well, hey, Bill, how you doing?
I heard your show. It was great. And I never asked him what station.
Okay, the reason I'm just playing a whole bunch of this stuff is because if Dion is in North Bay Village, maybe he'll send us a lot of money or something. You know, just as a gift. Okay, let's go to Broward. Hello. Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to talk to Neil.
You're speaking.
You know what last thing Lucille Ball heard was?
Come on now. That's terrible. Yeah. Dade County, hello.
I want to take all over Glen Hill shoes.
Ooh. That's her again. That's her again. You believe it?
Did she say what I think she said?
Now, so help me God, if Donna calls in and you put her on the air today and you let her go, I will never speak to you again as long as you live.
That's not the Donna.
Yes.
She called in earlier. Yeah. Not that earlier. Yeah. She called in.
Donna called?
This hour, yeah.
There's no way that Donna is going to...
Oh.
You sure? You never know with her.
She calls us.
Oh, yeah. Like, for the last couple of weeks, she's been sending us all these glowing cards, and she loves us and all of this. And then, somehow, she didn't get on the air or something. Somebody screwed up. So right away, we're idiots and we're morons.
That's right.
And she sends this hostile card. Man, you talk about manic. Mm-hmm. God. It is frightening.
Hundreds of collegiate baseball teams be...
Stan's topic today, illegal aliens who have not been on the Geraldo show yet. And let's take a call
both
from...
of them.
Boca, hello.
Yes.
Yes, sir. This wait a minute. This is the... I'm sorry, yeah.
Yeah, what?
It's fun to stay at the YMCA.
Dade County, hello.
I thought it was Sandy's Jerry, not Jerry.
Boca, hello.
Neil Bird.
Broward, hello.
Oh, Neil, you used to be such a nice boy.
Jay Michael's taking time out from his busy schedule to call in. Next thing you know, Dr. Votz will be calling in from the trunk. Dade County, hello. That must have been Rose calling in from the...
It was.
...music room at Zeta.
Yeah.
Palm Beach, hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yeah.
Hey, well,
sorry. Broward, hello.
Yo, Neil, this is Ralph, the real alien life form.
Dade County, hello.
Did he say Ralph?
No, feed Stan. Feed Stan. Right.
That was one of Stan's people. You notice how slow he was? There was that long, long pause at the end of the phone. Broward, hello.
Macho, macho man.
Dade County, hello.
Tim and Bob, douchebags.
Good call so far. Boca, hello.
You make me puke.
There he is. We never want to miss a day without that guy in the lightning round. Broward, hello. Dade County, hello.
Leland invited Abby to rejoin the firm.
Boca, hello.
It's not as bad as everyone says.
Broward, hello.
Cub suck.
Ed. Was that Ed or Ed
Sounded
Jr.?
Sounded like Ed.
I think it was Ed Jr. Broward, hello.
At 1-6.
Oh, Rose, come on.
It sounded like a Glenn Hill disease, didn't it?
You guys have turned the corner now.
Yeah,
come on.
To I-95. Dade, hello.
I'm falling down and I can't get up.
Boca, hello. Boca.
Those Boca calls. See, nothing.
No, nothing in Boca. Well,
don't start with Boca today,
Palm
Stan.
Beach.
How about that?
That must have been one of Stan's. Hello, Broward.
Neil?
Yeah.
This is Susan Lickman.
Broward, hello.
Genesis P. Orridge is a douchebag.
Dade County, hello.
Glenn Hill sniffs panties.
And he's proud of it, sir. Broward, hello.
Neil, it's been so long since I had sex, I forget who gets tied up.
Ask Disney. Boca, hello.
I'm dying over here.
Doc. Boy, pretty emotional for a Monday, aren't they? This is the most emotional Monday crowd we've had in a long time. Dade, hello.
Sam Major.
Yeah, real shame.
Yeah, now wait till Dave Martinez calls in. That's a little inside Cubs story there. Let's go to Boca. Hello.
I'm going to puke.
See, he'd be good once.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But when he gets that finger all the way down to his esophagus, it gets pretty disgusting. Broward, hello.
I feel good. Woo!
Broward, hello.
Yes, what time will the news be on today?
That must have been from Mayo, that call from James Brown. Isn't he up in Mayo? Broward, hello.
Yo, Neil, you're my greatest fan.
Dade County, hello.
I'm Mike Anthony.
Mike Anthony.
Was that Mike Anthony or Mike Jr.?
Wasn't it nice to hear from Mike Anthony?
You know something? It couldn't be all that bad. Wait a minute. Where's the card?
You know, we don't hear from him enough, you know, and I kind of get where I miss him.
What happened to that cart, by the way? It might not be as bad. Did somebody take that cart out of here? It might not be as bad.
You
Is that
played
gone?
It today, no.
I did? Yeah. No, I didn't.
You didn't?
I haven't found it yet. Oh.
I like to hear the winds, Bahamas.
No, I want it might not be as bad as everybody thinks, and I want it now, okay? Boy, when they come in here on a weekend and people start messing with these carts.
Even out to the Bahamas.
Yeah.
I haven't heard that for a long time.
Well, you can play it yourself, okay? Play anything you want. We're What's anxious to get out of here today. I don't see it.
It's
anywhere.
Called Wins.
It says it might not be as bad. Oh, that one?
Kicking ass.
That's under
what it
K.
Says?
Mm-hmm. As in
play that all afternoon for Kim.
Okay, Broward, hello.
Hey, guys, let's get buzzed.
I almost lost my buzzer. Boca, hello. Boca.
I've fallen, and I can't get up.
Palm Beach, hello.
I'm a Cubs fan and a Bud man.
That's enough for me. Broward, hello.
I am not a Nazi.
All right, now what am I looking for? It's not in here.
It's not, may not be as bad
as everyone thinks. How can it be gone?
Would it be under I?
No, it would be under here on the bottom. See where this ring is here? All the important stuff
is
under
the
ring. That's right, on the bottom. Dade, hello.
Hey, have you ever seen Bob Sofer and Froggy from the Little Rascals together before?
Good point, sir. Palm Beach, hello.
Is Stan going to walk off the show after 10 minutes?
Lee. I wouldn't blame him, I'll tell you that.
Must be a break.
Now, that
there.
Was Lee Fowler Jr.
Yeah.
Broward, hello.
Yeah, Sammy, can you hear me, Sammy?
Now, what are you pulling out? What? No, that's not it. It says it might not be as bad as everyone thinks. Boy, does that frost my ass, okay? Dade, hello.
Neil, is Uranus one word?
Dade County, hello.
It's ponderous over here.
Palm Beach.
They don't
Palm
talk
Beach.
Up there.
Yeah, that horse cut me off in the back stretch, man.
That horse cut me off in the back stretch. They're still whining.
I know.
Those 340 mm-hmm. easy-goer plungers, the bridge jumpers.
Mm-hmm.
Shame on you, sir. Broward, hello.
Only if...
Now, there was a true Stan Major yeah. call, okay? It's not in there, no. Hello? Nobody there either. Dade, hello?
Johnny Little, Dade!
Boy, that doctor and Dade, he's got to get himself under control. Some doggy downers might do the job, pal. Broward, hello?
Neil, you're a dork.
Okay.
Finally
Good
some
call, yeah.
Energy.
Finally something that made some sense. Palm Beach, hello? Now they're waiting. Yeah, they're waiting.
Have you noticed the lag before they talk?
Yeah, we'll put them on
Palm
hold.
Beach.
We'll be back to you, Palm Beach. Boca, hello.
This is Captain Briss.
Broward, hello.
For Stanley T. Major, no change.
Dade County, hello.
Arnie Becker can't represent Roxanne.
Dade County, hello.
Ozone crock of manure.
That Dick Fatherly man. Give him a little morning show on QAM and he goes nuts. Palm Beach.
Hello?
There he is.
Hello? Hey, honey, how about a nice big juicy ham sandwich heavy on the mail?
Oh, God. Broward, hello. Hello. What did I do wrong here somewhere besides come in this morning? Yeah,
what?
See?
Stand
yeah.
by for Neil. Have a good day. And until we meet again.
Dade County, hello.
I got into my biblical line.
Broward, hello.
I just want to be loved. Is that so bad?
Palm Beach.
Do you think Boom Boom would go to Siam's Doll and order chicken today?
Dade County, hello.
Do you watch us?
And last but not least... Should we do Boca?
You.
Yeah, why not?
Right.
Hello.
See the lag.
Boca.
No more puking.
Okay. Well, listen, that's going to do it for us, and it's easy for him to say. Personally, I'm sticking my finger down my throat all the way to my pupic when I get out of here today. You have no idea. Well, listen, Steve is under the weather today. He's probably a little too much birthday celebrating last night, so Stan Major's in the building, and we're going to have a little preview of what's to come on the Stan Major show today.
Kicking ass.
Okay. That's coming up in just a couple of minutes on the Stan Major Show from 2 to 6. And don't forget, right after Sports Talk Yankee and Texas Baseball, have a good one. And we'll see you, the good Lord willing, here on 610 WIOD.
Late is this afternoon, beginning at 2, to those wild and crazy guys, Rick and Suz, and it's 6 at Sports Talk 610.
Well, I'll be honest with you, after examining and fondling and pouring through these Tampa numbers, it only makes me ask one thing.
You got a dental floss?
Okay, 140. Now, I'm telling you, we're starting to get there a little bit. We're starting to eat. You know, once you start getting up into twos, man, then after that comes like threes and fours. And even if we never... No, seriously, I see you're laughing, but if we never go beyond freezing and fourth, they're going to be happier than a pig in shot over there. I'm telling you that right now. They're going to be dancing a Kazowski, and they don't even know what one is. And they start to give us a little bit of promotion, and I finally talk them into... I had to, like, have a verbal hernia to get them to put her on at night, and then they don't want to pay her a dime. Oh, she's an unproven quantity. Well, I guess she's not an unproven quantity anymore, you asshole. Tom... And that new GM over there who sounds like Bela Lugosi on a bad day, he comes out of the box for about 2 hours a day. They stick him back in there. God almighty. Here we are coming. When the hell do they ever have two eights and two threes in anything? Huh? With that damn nose-picking crap they had. We started like from zero. And as I said, FLA had a humongous. So Opie ought to be ecstatic, and we're ecstatic. Of course, he won't be happy until we all disappear, and that's not going to happen. Just out of spite, we're staying on, just to make his life miserable. And then when Cox goes over there and buys FLA and turns it into classical music and shuts his ass off, then they'll really show him a thing or two. Or when Buddy Bug comes over there and buys it and puts CNN headline news on 24 hours a day, that'll teach him a lesson. West Palm on the Star Line.
Neil.
How you doing?
How are you?
Great.
Actually, I'm in Fort Pierce now.
Well, you're really losing ground.
I'm really moving.
Yeah.
Well, I got to tell you, yesterday I had a shoddy day.
Really?
I had a really shoddy day. I busted my Scalises, and I get home about 11 o'clock last night, and I turn on the TV, and there I see, you know, Wayne Huizenga underneath the great big NHL sign.
Yeah.
And, I mean, that just, I flipped. I hit the roof.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's the greatest thing.
It is. Best thing that happened to us since sliced bread.
That's right. And I tell you, you played something this morning that I haven't heard in about 15 years.
Yeah.
Since I moved down here.
Yeah.
I could have sworn I heard the theme from Hockey Night in Canada.
No. The theme from Hockey Night in Canada? You mean that?
That's what I mean.
The greatest, man. I get goosebumps every time I hear that.
I mean, it just really, it started my day out just right.
I think as a kid of tuning in 7:40 Saturday night, CBL in Toronto at 8:30, hello, Canada and hockey fans in the United States. Here, Bill and Foster Hewitt from the gondola at Maple Leaf Gardens, and
uh-huh.
I just get goosebumps, man.
I tell you, when I heard that this morning and just now, I got goosebumps.
Well, it's like you said, one of the best things that ever happened to this town. We're going to put us on the map and get a little action going here.
That's right. I was really considering moving out of here. And then yesterday just said, no, I think we're going to stay.
Yeah, man, when we bring back Johnny Bauer, man, that's going to turn me around.
I want to see Bobby Orr play.
Bobby Orr and Derek Sanderson and Johnny and Frank Mahovlich. We're bringing them all, man. Red Kelly. And Mark Rayom. And Manon Rayom.
And Allie Efren.
And Tim Horton's bringing the donuts.
Is he?
Yeah.
Good for him.
So have a great weekend, eh?
You too.
See ya. Have some ham, Johnny. You should have come in earlier when it was still didn't have that green stuff on it. It was delicious. Okay, let's go to, so we're up a little bit in Tampa. We're starting to make little inroads over there, Johnny, huh? Well, we did a little bit better. Nothing spectacular. Randy kicked just oozing ass at night. 12 plus on this show went from a 1.4 to a 1.7. At night from a 0.6 to a 1.4. 12 plus 25 to 54, and we're starting to do some number over there. How do you like that? Like in the midday from a 1.4 to a 1.8, and at night from a 0.9 to a 2.4. Yeah, good Lottie, Miss Claudie, man. And that even includes a little bit of that Phil Swill Hendry. So you know that between 8 and 11, she is kicking big, big, oozing, pus-filled donuts, as Tim Horton would say. You bet. And they don't want to pay her? They ought to be running over here this weekend with buckets of money. Say, Randy, here, take it all, man. As much as you want, honey. You are a goddess. You are a godsend. You're the savior of WSUN and Cox Enterprises, and we will never treat you like a shot again. But they won't do it, and she's still going to have jump up. Not because they're a bunch of cheap assholes, that's all, with their $8 billion, and they're, oh, yeah, we know it all. You don't know shot, man. That's your problem over there. If you'd listen to anybody for once in your life, if you'd make up your mind what you want to be instead of this here and there and all over the damn place, make up your mind what you want to be and do it instead of this, oh, let's get the heat from QAM so we can screw up Randy some more and, like, you know, let QAM have that garbage. And be an entertainment station and stop trying to be like this full-service crap like they were doing 20 years ago. That was a bomb then, and it's a bomb now if you try to do that. You can't, in a major market, be all things to all people, man. It's ridiculous. God, they're frustrating. And the people think, oh, there he goes again. I'm telling you, these are the most frustrating people in the world to work for because you can't move them. You can't shake them. You can't move them. And the faces change, and they smile, and they nod their head, and they still do a bunch of crap. North Miami.
Yeah, hi, Neil. How you doing?
Wait a minute. Hold on a second, okay? Now, Johnny Dark is here, a radio maven. Not really. I suggested this morning the greatest move in history. Hot 105 is coming up. Howard Stern Morning Drive on Hot 105. Can you imagine what this company could do in this market? And none of the fanatical certain individuals could attack Howard because he'd be on Cox Broadcasting. You know what I'm saying? And so they couldn't mess with his show and with the content. We'd have it made in the shade. Howard in the morning on FM on Hot 105. We'd be coasting it. We'd be doing our thing over here. This company would, like, own this market. Oh, gee, we don't want to have to put up $500,000 a year for Howard. Oh, God. They'll actually want to have to pay somebody. Of course, they probably bill like $3 million on it. Like Infinity, I think, bills $17 million a year in the morning on K-Rock. But, oh, we don't want to do that. Anyway, yes, sir.
Yeah, hi, Neil. I just want to correct that shothead who called in with the other definition of shot.
Yes.
Between a tug and a barge.
Because,
you know, I've been in the merchant marine for 10 years, and this is guys like this who shouldn't be allowed on the water.
Really?
Because shot is in anchor checking. It's nothing to do with towing. You know, these guys, they should be out there on their boats with that Canadian license plate. Je me souviens. Yes, I can't drive.
With that bridge tender.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's the man I want to see right now. I want you in here right now, Bob Green. No, have a nice day, sir. I want this man in here right now. He's a good guy. He's a great guy. But I want some action. I want Howard on Hot 105. I want the triple deck cart deck over here. I want some copy in this thing. I'm going to be like Mark Clayton. I. Me. That's not kosher, by the way. That's not kosher. Oh, you're going to hell now. You're already going to hell. You work for this company. And you hired David Paul, so that locked it in. So we made a... Did you hear what I suggested? But you won't do it. But they won't do it. They won't do it. They won't do it. Bob Neal won't do it because it costs money, okay? And the notion that spending money to make money is like saying a shot in this company, man. You just can't even say that. They start like hyperventilating up there and start fondling their beads. Or something. Isaac Stern, a violin music. Why don't you buy FLA and put Isaac Stern on 24 hours a day? I think that's coming next. Watch out, Opie. We're coming. So we made a little inroad up there, huh? And how do you like Randy making some real serious inroads? And we don't want the heat at night. I'm telling you, I'm begging you. I want you to make a commitment to us right now, right in this room, that we will not carry the Miami heat at night on WIOD, that if we do have it, we'll tape it and play it at 3 in the morning or something. No, seriously, don't mess with success. Give her a chance. Give her a shot. In fact, that's what they're giving her right now, a shot. That's what they're giving her, a big one. I'm telling you, we've got a goddess here. She's going to do like eights and tens at night. And it's there. It's there to be done. I remember those golden glory days, if I can say that, at W Studios when I was doing 10 and 11 shares at night. The audience is out there living and breathing ones she's got. The ones I had were like over the edge of 100, but at least they were out there. Yeah, I can call a hockey game. I'll do the hockey right now. That's another thing. I'm doing hockey games, okay? I've done hockey. I know hockey. And believe me, you ain't no goalie. 149. You ain't no Johnny Bauer. 149. What am I talking about? I'm hyperventilating from those damn cookies. I ate them like 4 hours ago, and I'm still psychotic. God, they were good. But I'm spinning like a dreidel in here all day from that food. And that's another thing. Keep the food out of here, Bob. Tell that sales department to cut the crap. Take the whole thing, man. Take it for the party tonight. It'll be good and right by that time. 149 at WIOD and the moving up rapidly WSUN.
News, traffic, and weather tomorrow morning here.
You know, I'm looking at this microphone. It doesn't sound any different. It's like split wide open. Look at that. Look at that. Remember that record by Rick Nelson, My Bucket's Got a Hole in It? We got a new one. My mic's got a hole in it, man. A big one. And my mic, too. Look at that. Look at that. Have you ever seen anything like this place?
course, the fact that I dropped it on the floor a couple of times, that might have something to do with it.
This engineering department, man, I wouldn't wish them on Hitler. 154, and let's do North Miami Beach. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing? I have a number for you for the season tickets for the South Florida hockey team.
How can that be?
It's in the paper, in the Herald.
Are you serial?
I'm serial.
Well, how can they be selling season tickets when we don't even know what year we're starting in?
Well, they're taking the name and number, and they're going to send the information.
Okay, let me have the number.
It's 832-3000.
832-3000.
Uh-huh.
That's in Dade.
No, it's a Broward number, I think.
It's in Broward?
Yeah, I have to dial 1305.
832-3000.
Uh-huh.
Thanks a pile.
No problem.
See ya.
Bye.
I will be there, man, with bells on. I'm going to buy like 4 season tickets. I'm going to be the number one cheerleader. I'm going to be the Dolphin Denny of the hockey team. How do you like that? Well, not that much. Here's the lady in Boca. Hello.
Listen to that Neil. Okay. Let him hear from a listener.
Okay.
Get that cackling idiot off the radio on the weekends.
Yeah.